Can't see it. Beautiful night. What time are we talking here, Zen, right here?
10:20, September 12th, Saturday night. First cemetery we've done in quite a while, and I'm pretty excited about it. Couldn't ask for better conditions. You got some bug noise, but nearby road, I'd say it's a good half mile away. Not much traffic, so
yeah,
we shouldn't have anything messing things up too much. Just a question if we have an issue on fog. Again, I think we're up here a little high.
Yeah.
That should help out too. But it's hard saying, it's pitch black out here. We have no idea how big this place is.
True.
I hear it's an old cemetery, but it's still in use. There's still fresh burials, so I can see just glancing in there some luminaries. That's, you know, you'll find that in the newer cemeteries. So got half the team here, Greg and myself.
Yeah.
So again, that should, if anything, cut down on any extra noises we can't identify.
True.
But man, we've been wanting to come to this place for well over a year since we got, you know, our maps and we're looking at nearby cemeteries, and while it's just the name itself, you know, just kind of stuck out to us, and the location, we thought it might be, you know, far removed from, you know, nearby towns, which it is. And that way, again, you're not going to have, like we've had in the past, people literally driving through the middle of a cemetery in the middle of an investigation. So at least, exactly. I don't see that happening tonight.
Right. Exactly. And a big kudos to the Sheriff's Department there.
Yeah, Cedar County Sheriff's. I called them ahead, as we always do, to let them know we're going to be out here. They took down our vehicle information, our cell phone number, and the gal even gave me directions to the place. So between them and Greg's new GPS, we didn't take one wrong turn getting here.
No.
So
got here lickety-split.
So that's a good omen.
It is.
So far.
So maybe we can do a little walkthrough now and see what kind of see what we're up against.
I want to get a shot too of that entryway. The new hands-free headset. Now this is extremely bright. I can't believe how bright that is.
Yeah, it is.
Doesn't seem as large as I thought it could be.
Interesting.
Yeah, this one's been toppled, but that's an older stone. 1860s to 1890s. That looks like a fairly old one there.
It does.
And number two, I've got the two lawn chairs. We find a few spots that'd be good you can hang to.
Yeah.
I like some of these are just fucking chunks, you know?
Yeah. I guess that's what happens when things start to get old, you know?
The gal from the sheriff's department I talked to, she actually said she'd come out here and help paint some of the fences a couple years ago.
Nice. Oh, the little house, huh?
Next to one,
1918. Yeah.
So it's really mixed up. Corner down here is kind of growing a little bit. Thank you.
Bit of a breeze, but not too much.
I feel it now. I think I'm going to start doing some flash.
Okay. So what it was the same before. Now this tree right here, this big one right here, before you even, when you just had sat down, I had a light going on. That must be that light right there. I wonder what that is.
Below the tree? We've always had good luck with trees, so I'll take my first shot of the tree.
Yeah. Because I don't know if you can see that there's a light off to the left of it there, kind of that stump.
Yeah, I see one there.
But in my viewfinder, it's like it's blinking, like different colors. It's kind of weird.
Like I'm not getting much in the picture at all. The tree hardly shows up.
Yeah. I had that at a different place too. I'm like, wonder what the heck that's all about.
It's like I got my lens covered, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. I don't think I see anything in that last shot. This thing, there's something on the ground that's bright blue. See those flowers have me excited.
Yeah.
That might be a nice orb right here, though, next to it. Kind of faint. That tree, yeah, here, up in the tops of it. And see, that one's kind of interesting. It looks like it's even behind the twig a little, see?
Yeah.
And we don't see that, like, ever. And here's something else. Off to the right side.
Yeah, that's what I was kind of looking at.
That even looks like a little happy face if you got a little imagination. But
yeah.
That's the one behind me at the first few shots. You couldn't even get, pictures. And here's down the line I got. Some of this could be dust. There's some color into that one. So far, yeah, it's something's happened, I think, a little bit. But I'll try a few more of this one tree you're talking about. What did you find yourself in it?
Well, I found a lot of temperature fluctuations, really erratic. And kind of what I've been going with is anything that kind of fluctuates around a little bit, going back to Bethel, you know?
Right.
See if there was anything to it.
Super, super bright. Let's see what that looks like. This is just aimed at the tree. That's like a super bright one here.
They had a nice moth right before you had taken that. Just kind of fluttered for a minute. Yeah, take another one, see if it's still there.
the EMF out too, and we'll see if that does anything.
Yeah.
We've had such good luck with trees in the past for whatever reason.
Yeah.
That, like, this tree here is so prominent, it's like the only game in town. So, you know, for what we've experienced in the past, you know,
right,
for us to focus on that, I guess, would just be
natural.
You know, yeah. You know what? I just had my lens cap on, too.
Ah.
Let's try another one.
I can see your flash.
Yeah, I get all kinds of stuff on there.
Maybe you got definition?
Hmm? Yeah. Well, here, just a second. Look at that. No, I don't want to do that. Yeah, I got all that on there.
This would be the upper corner, I guess you could say, off of the road.
Mm-hmm.
And this would be right along the highest point. As John and I were talking about how we ran into a bat. That's what I was kind of wondering about. So every time I look through the viewfinder and look up, I see something swoop down. I'm like, okay. Very interesting. Did you ever venture down to the other corner?
We haven't been down there.
Yeah.
It almost seemed like I was getting more, you know, a little orb here and there early on, and now nothing, you know.
It's not feeling like anything, huh?
Well, not saying it's feeling like anything, but.
Kind of had that presence in the beginning, and
you know, as far as
true,
you can hang out different corners and stuff.
Yeah, it is a little bit bigger than I thought it was, but it's still just I would say it has that little bit of feeling like there's something here, and that just seems like true of any spot, you know. It's just like it feels like it's holding back for some reason, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess I can understand that, you know. You probably been out here for so long and this and that, and you haven't run across people walking around it, you know, later at night.
Like what sets this one apart, like the gal at the police department said, that there's such a mix of old and new that, you know, there isn't really an old section or a new section. It's all mixed together.
Right. So true. This part does seem to be open a little bit, doesn't it?
Yeah, if you hear it in this hole, there's nothing here at all. There's some extra gravel along the fence line.
Yeah.
In other words, a lot of vacancy yet.
Yeah, for sure. Boy, it's a little thicker down here, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Is the grass a little thicker down here? Yeah. They got the nice lights going on. It's amazing. It feels so peaceful, you know it?
Yeah, it's really, like I say, other than a few bugs making some noise, it's super quiet.
Yeah. You ever figure out what it was?
No. There's, it's right next to the tree there. See? And off to the right. Off to that bench. Right there. Kind of irregular shaped. And any pictures after? I mean, there's nobody home there. I went around, you know, different sides and everything.
Yeah.
Ooh, who's that?
Oh, wait a minute. How'd they get in there? So now it's gone then, huh?
Yeah. And then I thought I did hear something behind the fence line here.
At this point, we don't know. Yeah. All right. It would have been nice to be able to see something right along in here. I've been stopped here for about 10 to 15 minutes. And I was carrying on a conversation. Hopefully a little EVP session. I had my temperature gauge out. And the temperature around me is 64 degrees. And I was having a temperature in the 54, so I was able to make it fluctuate a little bit, trying to communicate with something, and as far as I could get, and I don't even know if it's accurate or not, but it seemed to be a man who is above 30 and wasn't married, so hopefully I can get some audio off of this, but I was just asking questions and making the temperature on my temperature gauge fluctuate a few feet here, or a few degrees here or there, so that'll be interesting to see how that turns out. What's your last updates here from the last few minutes? Noticed anything weird, any pictures?
Yeah,
I mean, we were just talking about definitely some weird temperatures going on here, which, you know, I point at the base of the tree, I get a 60, you know, I go, you know, 3 feet over to 47.
Well, I'm questioning more and more the validity of, like, even my thermometer, the infrared, because I know I read somewhere that as far as taking air temperature, they were saying that it wasn't the proper piece of equipment to do that. I know mine is pretty much used for, like, if you're working on an engine or something.
Right, yeah.
It'll let you know how hot your metal parts are and everything.
Right.
But I think in the past I've had more realistic, more reasonable numbers going by. But ever since we stopped in here tonight, you know, are my batteries getting low in it or what, but holy cow, it's like 20, 30 degrees less than it should be.
Yeah.
So you end up scratching your head, you know. I mean, like, say if yours is a laser pointer type variety.
Yeah.
How can that really sense air temperature?
Right.
So I've been getting readings, you know, in the teens, that down to 15 degrees just 2 minutes ago here.
Right.
And you're not telling me it felt like 15.
Yeah. And we both definitely have different pieces of equipment, you know, to where maybe mine is a laser while yours is something else, or, you know, we're not using the exact same piece of equipment.
Well, and I think that's good and bad.
It is.
I think it's good that you have different ones doing it, but if you had both the same piece of equipment, you could also, you know, correlate better too. But
yeah. Well, I just figure, you know, as long as you're within a few degrees, you know.
Yeah.
And
but still, right just now, we were 20
exactly.
degrees off from each other, too.
So. Right. So it makes you wonder, like, what is up? And it's not like, you know, it's freezing. It's, you know, there's not a gust of wind. There's not, like you said, it doesn't feel like 15, you know. It feels a little bit cooler, but it feels pretty normal for this time of the year, I would say.
Well, and that's what I feel. You carry a thermometer like that, if it's able to read air temperature correctly,
yeah.
It's good to have. Like, say you're in a house, and it's 72 degrees up in a bedroom, and all of a sudden the whole place gets cold. Well, if you got a thermometer, then that's accurate, and you can pull out and say, holy cow, it dropped 20 degrees just now,
right?
And see it. That's significant. I mean, for me, when we were at that local theater, again, and we were in that little dressing room,
yeah.
And the thing shot up to 135 to 150, you know, and I was getting 80 off the heat duct. Well, that, to me, I think meant something to me then, too.
Right.
Like right now, activity-wise, this place, I've captured an orb here or there, but I think the last few minutes, the only activity I'm worried more about is mosquitoes moving in on me, because they are.
Yeah. And I've yet to get, like, a really good, solid, good photo.
Really? I've had a couple.
You know, to say, man, that is a nice, clear, boom photo. You know?
Well, we've discussed that before, too, as far as a flash. I've told you how there's nights I've been out in the cemetery, and, like, the whole night, nothing shows up. I mean, even headstones you're halfway close to, and your flash isn't even revealing those. Come on.
Yeah. And I don't know if that does mean that there's, you know, something in the air that, you know, is blocking the visibility down that much or something. Because, you know, it's not my batteries because I just change them.
Right.
You know,
right.
So I should be getting maximum kapow out of it here.
Like tonight, again, this tree, we've been several cemeteries where you take flash. And the tree, there it is.
Yeah.
And this one, you gotta be standing right next to it to see anything in your picture. I mean, I've got some nice photo programs that you hit the enhanced mode. It's amazing, like, you know, 95% of the stuff just pops out.
Right, yeah.
But, I mean, initially you should be able to see something.
Yeah.
Maybe two in a row right out here. I seem to get quite a few.
Is by that light there?
Yeah, a little bit.
As good as that blue one? I thought I'd see that one before. That's kind of one of your orbs within an orb type.
Yeah.
You don't see those too often.
No.
But, I mean, for tonight, we haven't seen a shot like that too often.
Well, I'm wondering if we're getting a little bit of dew in there too, you know?
Yeah, I know.
So I was kind of wondering, I had a few shots like that too, where it's like, okay, I think something could be going on here.
Yeah.
But.
But then you take a few more shots, and that should still be.
You would think.
In the area, it shouldn't just be gone again.
Right. Exactly. We're going, better back it up a bit here. All right. We'll do a little wrap up here. I'll let John do his speak his piece first.
Okay. Well, it's about 12:15 Sunday morning, and Greg and I hit this place pretty hard. I'd say about 2 hours straight, and no fog or mist really rolled in. I think both of us did catch some interesting orbs. I got, you know, one really deep red one there right at the end. That was pretty neat. I don't think we've seen any motion in any of them, which is kind of disappointing. And I know I myself and Greg too, we both had audio running quite a bit, did a little bit of conversation with it. Especially the fact that some of these are fresh burials, you know, just within the last year or two. So hey, it was great to be out here again for sure. Tested my little headlamp, that worked pretty well. But yeah, pretty clear. I'm in need of new batteries on the EMF detector, and I think we're leaving here scratching our heads about our thermometers, both of them really. If they're even the right type to be using out here. But I think something could be rolling in. Doesn't it look a little bit of haze maybe at some point?
At this point,
I'm looking down that way.
We could be.
But it was super great to get directions given to me over the phone, and the GPS worked beautifully. And then to actually get to a cemetery, and really nice fence, but it's open and you can go in.
Yeah.
And but again, like we stress all the time, we at least, I don't know, in this case really get permission, but we give the local authorities a heads up that we're going to be in the area, and we have contact numbers and everything in case they need to get a hold of us. So that's what we're about too, is being above board on all our investigations. So until next time, I'm looking forward to at least a couple more. I think Greg wants a couple more in the can by Christmas.
We'll make it happen,
but yeah, we'll see. We'll look forward to Halloween for sure.
Yeah. All right. Here, you can take one video, John. Something to play with.
Do I look as good as ever?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was it. I have to say, it was a nice night. I wish I was feeling a little more, not nasally, but, you know, that happens, and it comes along with the territory. I'd say we had really good feelings coming into it, you know, just that kind of a new cemetery, new feeling, things along that line, and it seemed to dissipate a little bit, just a little bit, though. It's a lot bigger than what we thought. We kept finding little corners here and there as we kept going all the time. That was kind of an interesting feeling. And John touched on that a little bit about the temperatures. Yeah, I don't think we really ran across that with any places before, really. I think we'd questioned it before, but now it's just, you see something that jumps around so much, it makes you really wonder what it's all about.
And I still don't understand about my flash, and John talked about that too. Just when we were walking around, you know, I put brand new batteries in there to get a better flash, and it just doesn't seem like the pictures come out really crisp or anything like that. So that's kind of weird, but, you know, like I'd move 10 feet away or 20 feet away, just seemed to, like, be decent again. So then I go crappy and back and forth. It's like, it's strange. It happened one other time to me, but not, I think, as constant as it was here.
Right.
And so that was kind of weird that it was constantly kind of like that. And I didn't see it in your pictures really that much at all, and so maybe one or two in the beginning, and then
mm-hmm.
it seemed to have, like, cleared away. So we did have a few trees here. We kind of predominantly hit the one in the center. I think that's where our temperatures kind of did what it did, and a few of the other trees were kind of that way. We seem to be hugging to the trees. I guess maybe that's a green thing we're into nowadays, you know?
Oh, yeah.
But it was kind of sad seeing a few tombstones that were tipped over. I don't know whether, I'm hoping it's natural that people aren't getting in here and wrecking things up, because it's just a terrible thought, because that's not what we're about. And, you know, we're here to preserve things and that. And I'd hate to think that, you know, somebody where I may be laid to rest someday is, I hate to think somebody's going to be in there vandalizing that or tipping over stones and stuff. And it's just, leaves you in a sad state, I guess you could say. And we don't encourage that in any way. And, you know, like I said, like John said, you know, we get permission, and that's pretty much what we're about. You know, we're here to learn. You know, that's our big thing here. We're doing a little research and whatnot, you know.
And I think, again, our audio could have some possibilities tonight, just from the fact that most of the time we've been outdoors, so much wind,
right,
that, I mean, forget about it. And here, I mean, we can deal, I think, with a few bugs.
Right, right. And, you know, it's just like I've been talking to somebody who's a little familiarized with things. It's like, I think we tend to get that feeling like it's, like nothing's going on. I mean, for sure, there could be definitely something going on here. It's just we're kind of desensitized a little bit to different things. You know, we're used to, you know, the way things look and, you know, certain sounds, and become a little more familiar with different things, you know. And so that kind of leaves it interesting. I think that's why it's nice looking back at the pictures, you know, and listening to the audio, you know, something like get excited about again.
Yeah.
But
before the snow flies, anyway.
Right, right. To where we will have to go and find a building somewhere here or there to huddle up for the winter time. All right. That sounds good.
Awesome.
We'll leave it at that. Thank you.
sure.
It almost looks like a full moon, doesn't it? Almost.
Almost.
Almost. Today, after a fine, nice snack from Gumby's Pizza, that was good. Today being August 3rd. And of course, it happens to be one of the hottest days around. Getting up to what, about 88? We had to go through a few loopholes to get there, but it actually worked out. We were going to go back to Missouri, but that didn't work out. John's not with us. At the present, he's up in Canada. Nova Scotia. Nova Scotia. So we'll see what happens tonight. Joe's here and Sean's here. So. But more needs to be said. Wow. That's crazy. All over a lot of this stuff. Where does that baby go back?
Just into that tree right there.
Right to that tree, but back to that tree too.
That's the last corner right there. You working anything, Joe, or are you just random?
I'm just totally random. I haven't really gotten anything too exciting yet. A couple bugs. I can see what she was saying about having these not trimmed up. Kind of sad. When I can get somebody in here to mow it, why can't they get the guy to trim it?
It's probably gotta do the football field after this.
It's like those people over there, they don't want to be over here with these people, that's for sure. This one just sitting by itself. What the heck? I gotta do this again.
What's that?
I'm getting something really weird.
Where are you getting it from?
Right in this little area with the dead tree and. I think I got one of those.
That's probably nothing.
Yeah, here it is. Kidding me? Got one of these huge. It's a bug.
Is it? No. Can't really tell from this angle. That's too far.
See how big that is?
Oh wow, yeah.
Be a bug.
It's pretty big. Yeah. What's it look like when you get close? Just a big blur? Maybe it's a spirit of a raccoon.
I don't know. That's what it looks like.
Ooh, I don't know. It's weird.
It does look weird. It looks a lot like that Michelin Man thing that we got up in Wisconsin.
Yeah.
When me and this other girl who was taking pictures, we were both getting the same thing. We called it the Michelin Man. Because I've gotten a lot of bugs, and this probably is a bug. But normally the bugs you can really... You can see full definition in the bug, even a small bug. You can normally get it right down to little eyes and everything. So, there's something up in the tree. I'm just kind of fascinated with this area right here with the dead trees.
Definitely.
Look at this weird little orb that I got up in a tree that looks like it's got a bite taken out of it.
Yeah, it comes like a spider web too.
Yeah, that's
weird. Right in the middle, yeah.
Very weird. Well, you can tell it's been a cool summer because I'm sweating.
I am.
And it really isn't that bad, but I'm sweating.
Oh, yeah. Same here.
Well, I usually don't like to sweat.
There's a couple things he'll sweat for.
These come too. This is kind of like Oakland Cemetery in a smaller way. Where there's also several of them that are kind of hidden around little trees and bushes and more decorative kind of.
Yeah. It's like each family has their own little...
Yeah. It's like, man, make room because...
Yeah.
There's people over there in the corner squeezed in pretty close. I don't know, I wouldn't want to be too close to a root. You get those roots coming too close to me, I don't like that. See, just once I want to take a picture and go, holy jumping, what do you see? Boom, that's what I see. I see Jack the Ripper standing there.
What is this in the middle?
I don't know, what's this real heavy? Yeah, what is this? Is this one of those squared out areas?
I don't know. Whoa.
It is.
Is it?
Yeah, it's like a board.
Oh, wow.
It's huge.
I don't know, but I'm still getting bit.
Okay, you know when you were at that other place? And that spirit got run off and all that?
Yeah.
Was that pretty heavy for you?
It was... never experienced to where I couldn't exhale before.
Yeah, that sounded pretty exciting.
I'm pretty sure you can hear it on the tape. I tried. I tried to exhale. I really did. I really did.
Look at this bug. This one for sure got all kinds of bugs.
Yeah, there's all kinds of bugs out here, man. This is a breeding ground.
Current this is, like some of those in the corner there look like somebody might have been buried here fairly recently anyway.
The last 10 years.
Yeah. Problem is, in order to even see some of these, a lot of the other places we've been, you take a photo and you look at it and you go, wow, you know, that's Mr. Robinson or something.
Yeah.
And these, like this thing here, kidding me? I'm just assuming there's somebody here. I'm not really sure about that.
I don't see any stones.
Yeah, I don't think there really is. But that's how overgrown this place is.
I think we definitely should have did a little weeding before we came out here.
Well, that's what
Kat said.
Yeah, that's what she said that got them all charged up.
It's really hot.
Yeah, I've been sitting in the air conditioning for a while.
Oh, all day.
Usually when you get a bug, though, they look like bugs.
What's the consensus?
It's hot.
I get a lot of bugs.
It's buggy.
69 degrees, Sean. It's not hot. Hot is like when it's 88 and 90.
Yeah, but 69, that's like as hot as it's been all July. I'm not getting a ton of orbs. I'm getting some bugs. I'm not, you know. I got one interesting picture that might be nice to compare with the Michelin Man, that we got a few of those, and Jesus Christ, a huge freaking bug, kidding me? I can compare the photo that I got of this big, huge bug thing to some of those from when me and Casey up in Wisconsin got some of those weird, you know, bug ones, and I got several that are like, you know, you can tell, like I just got one, it's a moth for sure, you know. And this one, you zoomed in, it looks just like that Michelin Man thing, though. It just no real definition, kind of rounded off with little blue edges, kind of just kind of not kind of ghostly looking almost, you know, but probably a bug still. But
yeah,
why, what's your feel?
Seems like there's something going on back in that back part, that's for sure.
That's a weird area back there.
Yeah, because I kept catching things out of the corner of my eyes. It's kind of like, what the hell is that? But you tell, some of these graves are pretty old, and they're just checking that one out. I'm like, yeah, that must be one of those that Kat was talking about from the Civil War. I'm like, yeah. Just so overgrown and nothing really written on it or nothing.
Yeah. That's the weird thing, you can kind of see that. You hear them, our other Bethany place with the older ones, a lot of times you couldn't tell, but you take a picture and it'd be like, wow, there's Sam Jones, you know?
It was always kind of, it's kind of weird when I was taking a few pictures back there. I kept getting these like red and blue lights.
Yeah.
But there's no red or blue lights. I mean, I'm like, okay, when I was taking it, I'm like, yeah, I'll get that in there. Okay. So I'd take it, but then there would be that, and then there'd be like red and blue right beside it.
Yeah. Hmm.
And it was like, no matter, you know, I took a different picture in another spot, and there would still be a red and blue light. Hmm. Or dot, as you would say, or something. But it's just weird.
Tempted to just go up for you?
66 degrees.
Man. You know, it's a weird big squared out area right over here in the middle, kind of. There's one of those big squared out, where they have boards and everything, like
keep it separate from anything else.
Oh.
What's your own interpretation?
On what? These gopher mounts?
Yeah.
They suck.
I think it's odd that the middle here is all like wide open. Like, well, we've still got plenty of space here. Yeah. You think the gophers are like respected buried here? Because it doesn't seem like there's a lot of gophers here. Yeah, it's almost like, I would guess if that's like you lift that up and it'd be like the Ark of the Covenant in there or something. Because look, there's inscription on there too.
Looks like he was only buried like 4 foot under. Mm-hmm. And I'd do this right on top to make sure he wouldn't get out.
Kind of like that other one that was kind of a squared, you know, rectangular area that had inscriptions on it at that, wherever it was. Doesn't really matter where it was, but there was something else kind of like that. This is weird. That's really weird. Wonder who Gilson's talking to right now.
Call a cell phone. I know one of you guys got it. You get something, Joe? Jesus. Next to it.
Nothing.
That one was from 1894. Fairly recent, 1889.
Oh, nice. Looks like they got a new headstone, though.
Must have. 1878.
I mean, look at the base and then look at the top of it.
Yeah.
Looks like it broke and then somebody decided to buy a new stone for the top.
Nice, very nice. It's kind of an interesting one.
Oh, what's that?
That's a neat looking one. 1878.
It's got pretty flowers growing right
now. Talking about this one, the bottom's all old and then the top looks like it's kind of newer. So it looks like somebody had their headstone broke and somebody put a new one on there.
Mother Rabbana.
Oh. Well, I'm not going to lie. I've never known anybody to replace a headstone after it broke.
For real. 1876. Family over here, right? That's weird. Do you think that would be a headstone, too?
Could be.
Must be. That's sad. That's got stuff growing on it. 1879.
Yeah, that's pretty incredible.
That's a picture unto itself, you know?
What was that?
That was some crap I threw in the woods.
Oh. You threw it?
Yes.
It's like, what the fuck?
It's just one of those mother things.
What's it say on top? H E I O
Edith.
Edith? Oh, I'm reading it backwards. Mm.
There's something in here that we still want to turn around the door.
I don't know, you see anything? That's a tree stump.
1851.
Wow. Age 20, is that what it said?
Yep.
Wow.
That's sad. Is that age 21 too?
Yeah, age 21. So we got some young people in here.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm in Robert. 1852.
Robert.
Yeah.
Died. On December 27th.
What did Joe say? That was a wooden part in or something?
A what? There's a what?
Said there was a place that was kind of flanked out.
Yeah, it's back that way.
Back in the corner?
No, back that way. You totally blew by it.
Burge. Johnny Burge. That's where the Burges come from. This seems intriguing back here. This must be fairly newer. Not even yet.
Not even did. Oh. 2006, Ruth.
Ruth. They're all named Ruth.
Oh, that's the last name.
I wonder if there's a baby that died in there somewhere.
First joke of the night.
That one over there in the deepest of the deep, to the right even further.
They got that corner back there. And there's some dude that, I don't know, couldn't afford it, I guess.
That would be a roof there, otherwise.
Yeah, that's kind of too close for it.
That's it. We covered this thing in 30 minutes.
Look at the fog over there.
Yeah, it's coming in.
Yeah, you're starting to get those weird kind of pictures?
Yeah, a couple.
As you can see, the ground is already moist.
Yeah, most of my, yeah, I have white grass.
Sucks it had to be so hot this morning, or this afternoon. We had a nice cool day, man. Could have came in here, would have been nice. Maybe not so many bugs.
One never knows.
Well, I think we've been on plenty of investigations to know. And these cemeteries are my favorite.
I think they should have a little bit more trimming action going down here.
This is as good as it gets.
I think JCPT is going to have to come out and do some work. Do a little community service.
I know Joe's all about that.
We can get the women of JCPT out here.
Yep. On a real hot day.
I can call a couple girls up.
All the JCPT.
All the women.
Call in a couple favors.
That tree looks cool though. I'll give that tree a nice effect. I like this because it has the whole Bethel feel and age about it.
Yeah.
It's got some character. It's very small.
Yeah, fuck.
But it's also equally old. There's probably older stones in here than there is than Oakland ever thought they had.
It's not in that shot. Yeah, that 1850s feel. There's a green one in a tree. There it is at the top of it.
I got a few bugs up there. You remember you got lightning bugs out too.
Yeah. Like, right straight in there, I got like this, it's totally solid white. That's gone now. It's over to this tree.
Sure it wasn't the light? I got a big bug flying out in the middle.
See, it's over here. Then it was right in the middle.
Can you zoom in on that? Oh wow, that's a light. That isn't a bug.
That's a light, it's not a bug.
Yeah, wow. That's pretty exciting.
See, Sean?
That's better than your average at all.
Oh wow, yeah, it's pretty bright.
Yeah.
There was a things that I was getting are definitely...
I think it just goes back to the next one.
Yeah.
But I had two of them. That was the first ones in that, and then I moved over to that one.
All of mine have been bugged. Except for that Michelin Man thing. Which could just be a closer up bug.
Yeah. Enough of that tree.
I'd love to catch Mothra around here somewhere.
That'd be sweet. See that one, that same white one's right above that tree. The previous one, I had one in that tree and one in that tree, that same white.
Maybe it's time to run the lobby over. I'm gonna run some more bug repellent.
It's got a good feel to it.
It'd have a better feel if it wasn't 50 feet away from the county road and a mile away from the interstate.
Right.
yeah.
I think the worst thing that there was the full moon.
Yeah, that
and it's
help.
Wide open.
It doesn't help, but if there was actually, like, which we haven't gotten yet, any, like, real shadow action going down, you know?
That would help if there was, you know? The best action I've seen as far as shadow goes.
You call that a bug too, Joe?
I don't know, zoom in on it. That looks like another light to me. Yeah, it looks like a light again.
Does that look like another light again?
Kinda.
Something here, but it just...
I can tell it's getting misty because my hair's wet. Very, very strange. Very strange how it's not. There's so much open area in this.
I wonder if this is like kind of a private lot for certain families, you know what I mean? Oh, really?
Yeah, because the one that she takes care of is on the other side, which is like St. Joseph's or something or whatever.
Huh. They got a lot more going on over there?
I don't know. They got a church, and I guess they said it was kept up a little bit better, but this isn't too bad. But, you know, you see something like that, I wouldn't even know how to begin to weed something like that.
Yeah, I know.
Because there's some nice rose bushes in there and stuff. One does
very odd.
It is. But I mean, this is a good hunk of land.
Yeah.
They got compared to some others that I've seen are just, you know, 8 by 8 foot, you know?
Yeah, I mean, they got plenty of room for...
I ran across this one in Indiana when I was going to get something to eat. And I swear it was like the biggest one I saw. It was like Bentonville, Indiana or something.
Yeah.
Something you never even heard of. It was like 6 blocks by 4 blocks.
Wow.
I'm like, holy cow.
There's a huge one up in Wisconsin too, up in Beaver Dam. Really big.
And it just seems like the more people that you would have there, the better chances you would think you'd get something, you know?
Yeah. I'll wrap this baby up. But
all we need is to have something for something to happen out here, and then we're not going to have it.
Yep. Here we are on a beautiful, just about full moon evening.
Just about a full moon evening. Only a lot of dew coming right now.
Feels hotter than blazes. Must be 65, 67 here.
Hotter than blazes, yeah. A beautiful, yeah. 66, 69 degrees, and we're all sweating our butts off with mosquitoes all around us. And Sean's been getting bit so many times, you may need an IV after this.
Probably got the West Nile now. Shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. Never know.
So we had to check this out because Kat had an experience out here.
Yes. Cad was digging around a few of them, trying to find the date on somebody, some of these gravestones, and they said all these spirits started talking to her that wanted them to clear her grave off, yeah. Their graves off. I thought it might be worth a shot. What the heck? You never know.
Never know.
Got some audio, got some video, pictures. I don't know. You got like something like a Mothman.
Yeah, I got some kind of weird moth thing. Have to compare that to another one I got in another.
Exactly.
Out of state investigation, so.
I got some white lights that I don't know.
Yeah, those looked interesting.
I don't know if you can compare them to anything, but they're not like your seemingly like dew shots, but one never knows.
Nope.
But another great night in beautiful hills, Iowa.
Johnson County at its best.
Johnson County at its best. With some old markers, and I guess it wasn't a total loss. You know, we had some good pizza.
Good pizza. We'd like to thank Gumby's for supplying the pizza tonight.
It was nice. It was very nice.
I'd recommend the pizza to anybody who's looking for a tasty pie.
A tasty pie. Yes. Sean, any comments?
I like the pizza.
We need to get Sean on here.
Try the marinara.
There's Sean. He's trying to wipe his forehead.
Fucking hot out here, man. No, it's really open, really spacey. A lot of old stones.
Really, you look weird holding that light like that, Sean.
Do I? Oh, sorry.
Well, there we go. Yeah, yeah.
All right. Like I was saying, it's really open, really spacey. A lot of old stones. Right now it's really buggy, and it's not that hot, but I've been in air conditioning all day, so it seems like it's 100 degrees out here to me.
Yeah,
I haven't been out of the air conditioning for a week.
It's a good bright, it's almost a full moon, so it's pretty bright out.
It is nice for walking around, that's for sure.
Beautiful, nice cloud above your head. Kind of nice.
Got a mist coming in.
Yeah. I suppose we did hear a few things, but I mean, yeah, they're...
Got a duck in the background and eat up like no other.
Joe, too. He's getting eat up like no other.
Yeah. So, yeah. Not a big waste of time. It was not too bad. Got a few things. Pretty interesting. Hear a few noises. Hopefully we can get something out of it.
We shall see.
Good pie. That's a wrap. That's a wrap.